Legacy veteran, old family first fam. Taught the world to swing that double-edged sword, it works fam. BJJ from GJJ, like Cool Herc gave birth to what your DJ plays. But despite the lineage, I will never be closed-minded. Refuse to see beyond the lines, you go blind. Rocket travels the 10th planet, I flow free. I'm welcome on mini-mats, gi to no gi. Though my branch traces roots to the original tree, roots sprouted from the original seed. Water with blood, sweat and tears, spotlight with sunlight. That tree became a forest, Baletudo done right. Then Hoist dominated them all in one night. And hate storm hasn't been beaten in one fight. Flow with the goal, hit a hit on and holly know that to continue to win, we must continue to grow. Let's go!
We did it, mama, we did it. We did it for the love of the game.
We did it, mama, we did it.
I did it for, I did it for. Yes, yes, yes.
See you in a little bit.
Okay.
That's it.
What floor?
Six.
Man, this is total incognito show.
You gotta see when the door opens. There's no receptionist like area that you walk through. It's just mats. Very cool.
Everybody back dash.
Going to train with Marcella.
Where's Marcella at? I'm looking for Marcella. Looking for Marcella. You know this Marcella cat?
How you doing?
Doing good, man. Good to see you.
Looking for a man they call Bucho.
Can't believe
he's
gonna make that happen.
What? Hell yeah, that's good. Benny wanted to come too, but he likes to prepare a lot, do yoga and all. Where'd I put my gloves?
Hey, what's up, man?
Oh, yeah, man.
Sweet. There you go. Oh, shit. Got it.
Some guy, you know, I like Paul to show me this lock here. Oh, shit.
Yeah. All right.
Thanks, guys.
Getting the vice grip in, that's half the battle. Now I gotta bend his neck to get here, so this is half the battle. With the Japanese necktie, this is 90% of the battle. Because I come up with the ones that. Oh, that's Peruvian.
That's why.
Yeah, that's Peruvian.
I don't know.
Peruvian? It's alright. Japanese necktie.
That's what I'm speaking.
Yeah.
starting
your
too.
Wrist, your wrists are like kids, man. Your legs starting too.
That's the Roy Jones.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Seriously, you unhook the lockdown.
Because I know like how close you should be stuck over there, I try to feel as much I can, if it's possible. Man.
I think you passed my guard more times than Leo Vieira.
Come on.
Jesus Christ.
I'm glad I have the chance to train.
Dude, me too, man. Yeah. I didn't want to.
Been so long.
I didn't want to come by because yesterday, you know, Ryan's here. And, Damien, right? I don't want to piss Ryan off right now.
Nah, but they have their own problems. They're going to fight to unite, dude.
Yeah.
They're the ones that have to.
I just don't want, like, you know, politics and stuff, you know. You're stuck in the middle, you know what I mean?
Well, you know we don't have no.
Well, I know me and you.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
But Ryan and Danny don't like each other, you know.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
but they gotta deal with those problems.
Yeah.
They're the ones that
have to. Thank you for taking it easy.
Go on. That's the best training you can have, you know.
More rest 5 minutes on the okay. My legs are burning.
You don't like to be on top. That's why you take so much energy on the bottom.
There's no way I'm going to be on top of you.
You got to be first. You gotta,
there's no way I'm going to be on top of you.
You're going to be on top of you on the bottom.
That's the first time you guys rolled?
Yeah. That's cool. We've been trying to make you test for a long
time. Yeah. Yeah. We've changed techniques in Florida once.
Yeah,
that's
right.
But
it's been so long.
What year was that? 08, 07? That was the year.
One of the other, for sure.
That was the year Aoki and Jay-Z. That's why I was out there.
One of the other. But in Memphis, we got really close to.
What was that?
In Memphis, remember?
Oh,
you watched like a Joe Rogan comedy show.
There's people that want affiliate all over the world, and they might be a blue belt or a purple belt. If I wait for them to get to be a black belt, they'll be affiliated with someone else.
Right.
So I'm like, you know,
I gotta plant my seeds. You might make it, you might not.
You're right.
You can try it.
That completely makes sense.
Yeah,
but I see that happen a lot.
You gotta get them your little seeds. And hopefully they make it. Not all of them work.
I just wish them become more like close. You know? I mean, not just when I have a fish, I wish they come more like a visitor, you know?
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
I mean, school. You know?
I make that mandatory. You gotta come to headquarters. And then I go on to somewhere. But some make it, some don't.
Are you doing this? Oh, like here. I was like rushing.
I'm just reaching. Yeah. Reaction. Yeah.
Can you turn off video camera, please? Enough of the embarrassment.
Okay, no problem. No problem.
Y eso, Marcelino.
You okay? Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
I'm worried about your camera.
Jesus Christ. Try. That's the king right there.
No. I was just the king to be nice. To just be nice. And
being truthful. You know how lucky you guys are?
Yes, we do.
Since the first time I laid eyes on him, I say, be a tiger. I want him to be the teacher of my kids. No, seriously though, I know a lot of you guys know the story, but 2003, me, Joe Rogan, Mark Lehman, bunch of dudes sitting up in the stands watching as pure fans. I went to Abu Dhabi 2003 as a fan. I didn't expect to do anything. It's a music producer who got lucky at the trials. I'm like, damn, I get to compete with all these legends. And when I saw Marcelo beat that Japanese guy rolling around on his back like a crocodile, I knew, man, I knew that was the man right there. I knew that's the second coming. You know, first there was Jean-Jacques in Abu Dhabi, then come with Marcelo in Abu Dhabi. The two guys, the two finishers. Finishers, not winning by points. There's a lot of guys winning by points. But not Jean-Jacques, not Marcelo. They went in and killed, they didn't care about points. I saw that, after I saw him go against a Japanese guy, I told Joe Rogan, watch that little guy. See the guy with the little fro? See that guy right there? Watch him. And then he went against Hanzo, and I went down there, ran down there. I was like, I think it was Renato Magno. I was like, oh, who is that guy? And they go, oh, that's Marcelo Garcia. I'm like, he's Mexican? I didn't think Brazilians win by Garcia. But anyways, from that point on, we were just big fans up in the stands, just screaming and yelling for Marcelo. And when he went against Hensel and beat him, we went crazy. It's like, how do you beat a legend like that? And I never even heard of this guy. And then when he beat Mike Van Arsdale, that was amazing. And do you remember when I'm sure you watched the match with Mike Van Arsdale. His coach called him. He said, what? And then he got a heart break. And when little Marcelo was on his back, and then ever since then, I came back. I remember I just started working for the UFC, and I'm telling Lorenzo and Joe Silva, I'm saying there's this guy named Marcelo Garcia. You're going to hear about this guy. He's the best. He's just killing everybody. And they're like, oh, really? They weren't really grappling fans. I was trying to convince them. I'm like, you got to get this guy. And I talked to the guys at Pride. I'm like, there's a guy, Marcelo Garcia. He's the best in the world. You got to get him in the show. And just no one really cared. These guys they didn't understand. They weren't doing their job. The job was to have scouts going out, find the best kickboxers, find the best jiu-jitsu guys, and the best guys right there. I'm telling you about it. I'm actually giving you the information. And it's amazing how, it's incredible. But, and I remember, I don't want to name his name, but I told Marcelo about this. I couldn't stop talking about Marcelo and how amazing he was. And how in 2003, all these legends would jump on people's backs and they would lose the back control. You would see a legend after legend. Back control, they go double under, lose it. Back control, Kimura. Back control, roll. Everybody losing back control. But not myself. When he has your back, done, son. No one escaped you. One guy, I see one guy escape his back. Just one guy. Diego Sanchez. That was it, right? That's Diego Sanchez kind of thing. I would be happy too. Shit. To me, that would be a win. I escaped his back. It's amazing. You could write a book on that. Back escape. Volume 1. Mastering back escape. Right? But this guy told me, I kept talking about Marcelo. This one guy said, would you quit talking about Marcelo, please? There's other guys out there that are just as good. I'm like, who?
who's just as good? Could, you know, there's guys that are really, really, you know, really good, but Marcelo, no doubt, is the best. He's the best. Thank you for taking it easy on me.
Come on, no, you can't. It's a great train, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Woo! I really wish everyone understand like how much you, people like Eddie, me, I used to say Janjaki, a lot of people out there that really love jiu-jitsu, and we just try to do the best we can to just spread out jiu-jitsu. Like Eddie, he has just like such a different style than everybody else. You know what I mean? And you guys definitely know like how much he that improves just today. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And I believe I try to have my style. I try to do like the ways that I believe like is the easiest to most of the people. But not everyone understand that. But me and Eddie, we just keep trying like make things like new. You know what I mean? Make things like keep improving. And just to everyone is to have the same like passion, you know, from jiu-jitsu that we have when we start, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And now everyone gets so used to the same, we just hope to jiu-jitsu keep growing because we've been trying really hard, and from now to the end, I hope we have more people, you know what I mean, try and make jiu-jitsu just better and better, you know what I mean? You don't have to be stuck at the same thing from when you start. We gotta always like continue to improve, you know what I mean? And that's why like me and Eddie get along so much, because we just try our best to make jiu-jitsu become better and better, you know what I mean? And Eddie's just like we have a good thing together. Every time we get together, we just have a great time. It was just a shame we never could do this that we did today, you know what I mean? We really trained. It was just like a different like situations. And now with the situation was like, all right, we're on that mat, you know, in the same place, not too far. You're in the hotel, the gym is just so close. We gotta make that happen, you know. Yesterday we have a great soul food. That's what I'm... we just talked about that big part of my diet, you know what I mean? And that's why, like, I got into the soul food last night, and today we got the best juice we can do together, you know what I mean? And I'm sure you guys happy to have, you know, would be able to do jiu-jitsu in front of you guys, you know what I mean? You don't have to hide that, you know, you just enjoy so much jiu-jitsu and you don't mind to jiu-jitsu that get spread out more, you know what I mean? And I really like to everyone like respect that passion that me and Eddie have for jiu-jitsu, you know? And I'm glad you guys here. Enjoy that.
Best
place.
I couldn't do it without talking.
And I'm gonna get you in the sorcerer real quick. Okay, get my guard. No, my guard. This one, you're not gonna like this one.
As long as it survives.
That's a there we go. Stay. Hold that a second. Beautiful. That's good. Got it.
Oh, man.
That's a lot of media.
It's like a press conference.
I've
never rolled with someone, like, because you're like 180, 170, something like that. I never rolled with anybody 180 that strong. You know what I mean? You're so strong.
I feel everyone's stronger than me, Eddie.
No. No, man. You're like a
box. Oh,
your grip is crushing.
My hand is too small. I gotta make sense.
Do you do exercise when you climb rope or something?
No, I exercise right there. I try to hold it.
Well, you had my arm a couple times. I couldn't.
Yeah, you know, if you do audio, then you can
track. Oh, the best is when it's dry. It's dry, just like...
Woo! Now it's time for an amazing tournament.
What's that?
Right?
And good for you.
Oh, that, yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's
real. Yes.
Yeah, that's really
good. What time is it?
2:12.
Oh, shit.
You don't have power, right?
No, I don't have power. Triumphant, born with pride and abundance.
moments. Look up to the sky, hide a little smile and amusement. Never grow accustomed to losing, live and die for the love of this music. Cumbella thrives when the times are the toughest and truest. Keep in mind when the universe gets aligned, when the remnants of this verse are injected into your spine. There'll be evidence of this platform, we rock it all the time. Better in what we stand for, the anchor and the line. Straight slap on a joint if anybody provokes. I'm in it to win and rep it for my fam and my folks. This ain't just rap now, man, this is murder he wrote. It's like Mickey D's on the streets, if you look in the coat. You can compound your greed with an image of hope. Study the foul physics of falsified gimmicks. Ride and fall with it or try to ride. Got vision, come on.
We did it, mama, we did it.
We did it for the love of the game.
We did it, mama, we did it.
I did it for, I did it for. Yes, yes, yes.
We did it, mama, we did it.
The game will never be the same.
We did it, mama, we did it.
I did it for, I did it for.
Alliance, a tech planet rocking with Irish science, silencing all these idiots caught up in all their ignorance. Two clans fighting under the same banner. We all got love for this ground game, and that's all that matters. In the balance, the teachings of the grandmasters. I'm trying to master the system, that's what I'm after. And stay true to the craft, spark trees to relax. Old school miracle, lyrical lace in the track. And I'm working the angles, only sharp and precise, man. Back in the day when I was learning to rock in this mic, paying homage to the classic shit. Dilated, undisputed, heavyweights repping Los Angeles. And yeah, I throw this for the 213. The storm could flip down, you know I'm with that G. So fire in the hole, slick with the flow. High caliber rappers is here to shatter the fucking mold.
Come on. We did it, mama.
We did it for the love of the game.
We did it, mama. We did it.
I did it for.
I'm going to go on.